Hello everyone, welcome back to Obsidian Soft. In today's video, we're going to be learning how to connect the HC05 Bluetooth module to the Arduino so that we can wirelessly control our projects which we will make in the future. So let's get started. As we're only covering the connection and testing of the module in this video, we don't need a lot. All we need is our Arduino, in this case I have the UNO, the HC05 Bluetooth module, 4 male to female jumper wires, which can be identified by the fact that they have a hole at one end and a pin at the other. The wiring of the module is also pretty easy. Here's a little schematic to make it easy. In the top right you can see the module, and in the middle is the Arduino UNO. The red power wire goes from the VCC pin of the HC05 to the 5V pin of the Arduino. The black ground pin goes from the GND, also known as ground, pin of the HC05 to the ground pin of the Arduino. The TXT pin of the HC05 is connected to pin number 2 on the Arduino, and RXD is connected to pin 3. If later on in the video you find out that your HC05 module is not working, you can try swapping these last two connections. Usually swapping it fixes any issues you have. Now once that's all done, we can connect our Arduino to our computer and start programming it. If you haven't downloaded Pictoblox already, this is covered by me in the first video of this series, which I recommend watching. So let's open up Pictoblox and choose our board, which is the Arduino UNO in this case. The connection page pops up, in which I'm going to choose COM4, as this is the one which is connected to my Arduino, and the connection is successful. Now let's go to the upload menu from the top right. I'm going to start off by using the When Arduino Starts block to initialize the Arduino once it starts up. We are then going to go to the Dabble menu, which is the app used to connect to the Arduino, and choose the baud rate of 9600. We are again going to use a refresh data block. Next, I'm going to insert a forever loop block, which keeps running the code which is inside this loop. I'm going to then add an if block, which basically means that if this thing happens, then it will run the code inside it. And what's the if condition? I'm going to go in the Dabble menu and choose a terminal block. If data from terminal is, and then the text, meaning that once we open the app and send a message to the Arduino, it will check for that. In this case, the message is going to be hi. Let's just keep it simple. We're only testing the module in this video. We're going to do a simple reply. The Arduino is going to send us back a hello message. And that's all that's needed for the code. Let's upload it and move to the mobile. If you don't have the Dabble app already, you can download it from the Google Play Store, as shown over here. Once that's done, you can open up the app and you are greeted with so many options which you can use in your projects. However, we're going to be using these in later videos. I'm going to connect the HC05 module from the top right plug icon, making sure that your Bluetooth is enabled in the mobile phone, and then go into the terminal menu. Now we can finally test our module by sending the hi message we set while coding the Arduino, and we get a reply in the form of hello. This means that our module is working perfectly. And that's all for this video. In the next few videos, we're going to be making a few projects using this module. So I highly recommend liking and subscribing so that you don't miss out. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Goodbye.